Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron Mackenzie Lafergy. There are certain scientific concepts that most people have heard of but don't quite know what it implies. While you've doubtlessly heard mention of splitting an atom in school or films, you may have missed out on how exactly this can be done. So let's explore the wonderful world of nuclear physics. If you want more science videos, check out our Biggest Science Questions playlist on the channel. Now get ready, it's time to ask the question, how do you split an atom? Now you've probably heard of splitting the atom countless times before, but what exactly does it mean? Well, based on the vision of the atom created by Niels Bohr and Ernest Rutherford, it was believed that the atom could be split using a nuclear reaction. In 1932, this idea became a reality when Walton and Cockcroft managed to split a nucleus into two alpha particles by artificially accelerating protons against lithium-7. This eventually led to modern nuclear fission, where the nucleus of an atom splits into smaller parts to release huge amounts of energy. It should be noted that atoms are splitting around us all the time, through radioactive decay. Unstable atomic nuclei lose energy over time, emitting radiation in the form of alpha particles, beta particles, and neutrinos. Even everyday objects like bananas are technically radioactive. A banana has roughly 450 milligrams of potassium, and 0.01% of potassium is radioactive. This means each banana contains roughly 45 micrograms of radioactive potassium, caused by the splitting of potassium isotopes. However, let's keep with the spirit of the question and explore ways in which we can intentionally split an atom. One method you can use is the compression of radioactive materials. This involves obtaining enough of a fissile radioactive isotope that fission will continue. If there isn't enough, you can enrich the isotope, increasing the fissile isotope in the sample using gas diffusion or a centrifuge. Then, by compressing the sample, often with explosives, you can cause the atoms to push closer and closer together, increasing the chance of released subatomic particles striking and splitting other atoms. This is a method used to create plutonium-239-powered Fat Man, the nuclear bomb used to attack Nagasaki during World War II. But that isn't the only way we can split an atom. It can also be done by bombarding radioactive isotopes, commonly using uranium-235. As with compression, you need to have enough of the isotope to make sure fission will continue after the first split. Then, by firing atoms against others of the same isotope, you cause them to split, releasing neutrons, which in turn collide with other atoms, continuing the reaction. Alternatively, you can fire subatomic particles like protons, neutrons, or alpha particles at the nucleus of the fissile isotope. But hey, this is 2018, can't we just do this ourselves? Well, in a word, yes. But it can be pretty tricky. One particularly impressive example of this was made by Dr. Michio Kaku when he was in high school. By winding a 22-mile-long copper wire around a football field, generating a magnetic field 20,000 times greater than the Earth's, he created his own version of the Large Hadron Collider. If you do this, it would allow you to smash ionized atoms into each other, resulting in a change to the atoms. If you want to actually see the particles, you can build a homemade cloud chamber. A video showing you how to do that is linked down below. Bottom line, you can try this at home. But since it can be dangerous and I don't want to get sued, I'd advise not trying this at home. So now we know the history and mechanisms behind the splitting of the atom. But what use is this to us? Well, first, as previously stated, nuclear fission is often used to create nuclear weapons. This was one of the most regretted discoveries of the 20th century, taking millions of lives in World War II. But it certainly showed the power one could wield thanks to fission. Thankfully, this power has since been wielded in more constructive ways, with fission also being used in nuclear power plants. These plants use fission reactions to release nuclear energy, which generates heat, which in turn is used in steam turbines to produce electricity. As of 2014, nuclear power accounted for almost 20% of electricity in the United States, and ironically, 27% in Japan. So not only has nuclear power provided a job for Homer Simpson, it's provided power for millions. Good job, atom splitting. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. I hope this was interesting and informative, and maybe even inspired you to look into it further on your own. Just don't go building a nuke. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe to the channel down below. While you're down there, let me know what other science questions you'd like answered. Until next time, I'm Ron Mackenzie Lafergy with Life's Biggest Questions, wishing you the best of luck on your quest for answers. We'll be right back.